Over 1400 years ago, in the deserts of Arabia, a man named Muhammad had an experience that would change the world. According to Islamic belief, Muhammad was visited by the angel Jibrail while he was meditating in a cave near the city of Mecca. Those who follow the Islamic faith believe that the angel, who Christians call Gabriel, revealed to him the words of Allah, or God. Jibrail's revelations to Muhammad are the origin of Islam and became the Quran, the primary sacred literature for Muslims. Since its birth, Islam has had a profound impact on the world. In fact, the followers of Islam, called Muslims, has steadily increased over the centuries and today comprise the world's second largest religious group. That leads us to today's world history mystery question. How did Muhammad's teachings spark an Islamic golden age that continues to shape the world today? To answer the question, we'll gather clues as we investigate how major cities facilitated cultural growth, key figures and their contributions to Islam, and advancements of the Islamic golden age. Are you ready, historians? The Islamic Golden Age was a time of tremendous growth for many of its empires and the religion as a whole. Several key cities played crucial roles in promoting cultural growth during this time. See if you notice a commonality among these cities. Baghdad, now the capital of Iraq, was home to the House of Wisdom, a renowned center for learning, research, and translation. The city was also capital of the Abbasid Caliphate, or kingdom, which had been founded by Muhammad's uncle and claimed to be one of the true successors to Islam's founder. In Baghdad, scholars from various cultures gathered to translate and preserve ancient texts, conduct research, and share knowledge. The city became a hub for scientific and cultural advancements, producing many groundbreaking works of the era. Cordoba in Spain was another important cultural center. The city was known for its architectural marvels, including the Great Mosque of Cordoba. Remember that Islam developed in Western Asia. What do you think an Islamic temple of worship in Spain tells us about the religion? The Great Mosque in Cordoba was evidence that Islam had spread into Europe, where Christianity remained the predominant belief system. Cordoba was also a center for learning and cultural exchange, where scholars from different religions collaborated, contributing to a rich intellectual and artistic environment. Damascus served as the capital of the Umayyad Caliphate, an Islamic kingdom that predated the Abbasid. The Umayyad Mosque in Damascus is one of the oldest and largest mosques in the world, symbolizing the city's importance. Following the death of Muhammad, Damascus played a key role in the early spread of Islam and the development of Islamic art and architecture. Cairo, today Egypt's capital city, was a major center of learning and religious scholarship. Al-Azhar University, founded in Cairo, became one of the leading centers of Islamic education. The city's scholars made significant contributions to various fields, including science, literature, and theology. These cities were vibrant centers of learning and culture, where scholars and artists thrived, and their contributions helped shape the world we know today. Study this map showing each of these four cities. How did their locations help spread Islamic teachings? Pause here to respond. These four cities were crucial for the spread of Islam. Their strategic locations, scattered across three continents along important trade routes, led to the rapid growth and influence of Islamic teachings. All four cities became centers of learning, worship, and cultural exchange, which, combined with the location on significant trade routes, helped contribute to the spread of the religion as well as the development of the Golden Age. Many individuals contributed to the Islamic Golden Age, spreading the religion, leading empires, and making lasting contributions to the world. Osman I started the Ottoman Empire in the late 1200s, starting with a small area in modern Turkey called Anatolia. Under his leadership, the Ottoman Empire grew into a powerful empire which lasted for over 600 years. Do you remember anything else about the Ottomans? It was the Ottomans who controlled the Holy Land at the end of the Crusades and also conquered Constantinople to mark the end of the Byzantine Empire. Osman I spread Islam through his conquests and leadership, making the Ottomans one of the most important empires in history. Mansa Musa, the ruler of the Mali Empire in West Africa, is famous for his pilgrimage, or journey, to a holy place, to Mecca, in 1324. Musa's journey showcased his immense wealth and generosity, as he distributed gold and gifts along the way. Musa's pilgrimage brought attention to the Mali Empire and highlighted the richness of West African culture and resources. He promoted Islam by building mosques and Islamic schools called madrasas throughout his empire, encouraging education and religious teachings. How do you think Mansa Musa's journey to Mecca influenced people's thoughts about African Islamic empires? His pilgrimage provided a new perspective for many and helped establish Islamic empires as a model for others around the world. And perhaps you recall Saladin. Also known as Salah al-Din, he was a prominent Muslim leader during the Crusades. He is best known for recapturing Jerusalem from the Crusaders in 1187. Saladin was a skillful military commander and diplomat, respected by both his allies and enemies. He promoted Islam through his leadership and support for educational and religious institutions. Like Mansa Musa or Osman I, Saladin helped strengthen the Muslim world and left a lasting legacy in both Islamic and Western history. So let's think for a moment. How did key individuals and major cities contribute to the spread of Islam and ideas on science and other topics? Pause here to respond. These leaders and cities promoted Islam across the continents, leading to its rapid growth. Both also contributed to the development and expansion of Islamic empires. Individuals such as Osman I and cities like Baghdad played crucial roles in shaping the history and culture of the Islamic world by emphasizing the religion, learning, and knowledge. Muhammad's teachings and Muslim beliefs spread rapidly, soon uniting the Arabian Peninsula under a single religion. Within a few centuries, the followers of Islam expanded their reach far beyond Arabia, creating an era of incredible achievements known as the Islamic Golden Age. During this time, there were remarkable advancements in science, technology, arts, and literature. Muslim scientists and scholars made groundbreaking contributions that still affect our lives today. Islamic mathematicians were among the leaders of the Golden Age. Their work introduced the concepts of algebra and algorithms, which are fundamental to modern mathematics and computer science. In medicine, Ibn Sina wrote The Canon of Medicine, a comprehensive medical encyclopedia that was used for centuries. He made important discoveries about diseases and treatments, helping doctors understand how to care for patients better. Muslim scholars wrote extensively on various medical topics and made significant contributions to understanding diseases and treatments. Ibn Sina's work influenced both Islamic and European medicine. Astronomy also saw great advancements. Muslim scientists made significant contributions to optics, the study of light. Their work helped us understand how we see and paved the way for the development of cameras and eyeglasses. Arts and literature flourished during this period as well. One of the most famous literary works from this time is 1001 Nights, a collection of stories that includes famous tales about heroes like Aladdin. Islamic poetry has inspired people for centuries with its deep spiritual insights and beautiful language. Much of the work from this era continues to be widely read and appreciated. So which of these accomplishments from the Islamic Golden Age do you think had the biggest impact on your life and today's world? It's clear the Islamic Golden Age was a time of incredible creativity and innovation, with scholars and artists making lasting contributions that continue to influence our world today. So, would you agree that the Islamic Golden Age is a fascinating and significant period in history? It's amazing to think that all these accomplishments and contributions that shaped the world began with one man's reported encounter with an angel. Let's move this mystery to our solved folder and look ahead to our next investigation. Next time, we stay in the region to check out African kingdoms during the Middle Ages. Until then, keep exploring the past and shaping the future. And remember to always be clever. Hey.